dignitaries on and off the dais, and student managers. I'm privileged to introduce the guest of the evening, Mr. Vishal Merrani, Secretary to Gurudev Sri Sri Ravi Shankar, on the auspicious International Yoga Day. Mr. Vishal Merrani holds a BTech degree in Electrical Engineering from Indian Institute of Technology, Delhi. He was awarded the prestigious Erasmus Mundus Scholarship to complete his double masters in Molecular Bioengineering from Germany and Nanoscience from the Netherlands. As a student, not only was he brilliant at academics, he was also excellent in sports and cultural activities and was conferred the Best All-Rounder Award at IIT. A consultant's job... This is not enough, there's more to him. So a consultant's job offer at Accenture Amsterdam could not charm him from attending to his real calling. Inspired by Gurudev Sri Sri Ravi Shankar Ji, Vishal joined the Art of Living as a full-time volunteer immediately after completing his master's. He has been a trainer of the Art of Living Happiness Program since 2008 and currently is the personal secretary to Sri Sri Ravi Shankar Ji. Over the last decade, Mr. Vishal has gained experience in conducting inspirational leadership programs, stress-busting meditation sittings, yoga sessions, and guest lectures for thousands of people from all over the world, ranging from rural youth of India to heads of states of different countries, from college freshmen to corporate directors, from Iraqi youth to American war veterans. A multi-dimensional personality. He is an amazing motivator, a keen meditator, an avid sportsman, a yoga expert, a writer, and he likes to dabble with music and musical instruments. He speaks fluent English, Hindi, and a bit of Kannada, Tamil, Punjabi, and German. May I now request Mr. Vishal to enlighten us with his words of wisdom. Thank you.
Okay, hi everyone. Good evening. So, we hear about yoga and the benefits and all that. How many people here practice yoga or know something about yoga? Okay, not know something. How many practice yoga? Okay. So here we are. Let's see what happens with yoga. Yoga se kya hoga? So Patanjali Yoga Sutra, it says yoga chitta vritti nirodha. Yoga frees one from the modulations of the mind. Now what does that mean? Okay. Wo complicated, all those things, we'll just leave it. We'll just come to our practical reality. Okay? So tell me one thing. Have you all given exams? How many people have given exams? Raise your hand. Everyone has given exams. So, one night before exam, so the exam is tomorrow, and today, how do you feel? Stressed, but focused. Mind is focused. Okay, 1 month before exam. There is 1 month for the exam to go. Mind is relaxed, chill, no tension. 1 month before exam, suppose you decide that today I will study for 2 hours. I know it doesn't happen. And for exam, and wherever you go, it doesn't matter where you go. Huh? Even if you go to IIT, IIM, wherever you go, 1 month before exam, you decide and sit, you decide that you want to study for 2 hours. How much time do you really study? Huh? 10 minutes? Huh? 15 minutes? Achha, increase ho raha hai. Usually it is decreasing. Initially people say half an, some people say 1 hour, Sharma ke bolte 1 hour, so that, you know, impression kharab na ho. Then the reality starts coming in. People say half an hour. Then people say 15 minutes, 10 minutes. And the beautiful part is, the lower the answer, bigger is the smile. 10 minutes, huh? Padhta hi nahi. The best will be, the happiest person will be, padhta hi nahi. So, see, shamelessly smiling at our own inability. Isn't it? So, 2 hours you study, you decided 2 hours you want to study, and you study none, or maybe 10 minutes, 15 minutes, whatever. This is 1 month before exam. But how is the mind? Is it tensed or relaxed? Relaxed. So no tension. 1 night before exam, how many hours do you study? Full day. You don't even leave the time to, if you're even while eating food, you will have the book in the ek do formula padh lenge. Sometimes even going to the toilet, you have the, kyun chode bhai? Ek aur chapter ho jayega. Right? So, 1 night before exam, mind is fully focused. But is it relaxed? No. It's tensed. 1 month before exam, mind is fully relaxed, but is it focused? No. So if I tell you, everyone has this ability for the mind to be focused and yet relaxed at the same time. What is that? That is something that happens when you are naturally focusing or concentrating on something. Suppose you are watching a very interesting movie. You are relaxed and yet you are focused. You don't forget any dialogue, isn't it? Are you getting what I'm saying? Okay, let's put it to practice. So we will play a game now. The rule of the game, have you played this game? No. Some of you have, some of you haven't. It's not dependent on whether you have or not. So, the rule of the game is, whenever you hear the word clap, you have to clap. Whenever you hear the word stop, you have to stop. Okay? Rules of the game clear to you? Okay, start. Why are you clapping? Did I say clap? I said start. I said clap 5 times now, and still you have to clap 100% properly. Stop. Thoda tube light. At the moment you hear clap, you have to clap. And the moment you hear stop, you have to stop. Perfect. Well, the game has just begun, okay? So don't be so happy. Okay, clap. Stop. Clap. Stop. Clap. Stop. Clap. Okay, stop. Clap. Stop. Clap. Stop. Clap. Stop. Clap. Stop. Clap. Stop. Stop. Clap. Stop. Okay. Game is still on, okay? Anytime I can say clap. You have to clap 100%, remember. And any moment I can say stop. Clap, stop. Okay, game is still on. Acha, did you notice? Were you focused? By the end you were focused? Were you very tensed about this? No. See, everyone has this ability. Are you getting? Mind was focused and yet relaxed. Clap, stop, clap, stop. So all of us have this ability to be focused and yet relaxed. Okay. You can clap otherwise also. Stop. Okay. So, how many of us have experienced all these emotions? Anger. Greed, jealousy, lust, arrogance. There's a squeaky smile from people. Okay. So, we have all experienced, yeah? But everyone says you shouldn't be angry. You shouldn't get angry. How? Suppose there is this person who's really mad and very angry, and in front of you, you say, you know, you should not be angry. What'll he do? He'll get more angry, slap you back. Isn't it? Yeah? So, we are all told that you shouldn't be jealous. Okay, now you have this friend of yours who has a much better looking body than yours. He has two girlfriends. Gets twice as marks as you get. Lagta hai na, aata hai. What do you do? All these emotions come up in us. Everyone says you shouldn't have this, you shouldn't have this. But how? How? Yeah? Okay. What's your name? Tanvi. Tanvi, you have a very nice smile, very nice hairstyle, very nice personality, very nice dressing sense, very orderly. Sit down, Tanvi. Yeah, you can all clap. Stop. But Tanvi, your nose, no? It's little bit pakoda. Just kidding. Just kidding, huh? Okay. Now. Wait a minute. This is for everyone. Now Tanvi goes to her room and looks into the mirror. What is the first thing she is going to see? Pakoda mirror mein nahi hoga, wo kitchen mein milega. See, 10 compliments and 1 insult. What do we take? One insult, pakad ke baith jate hain. Hai ki nahi? How do you manage that? Now suppose somebody is throwing flowers on you and somebody is throwing shit on you. Where will you stand? Where someone is throwing flowers or where someone is throwing shit? But in life, what do we do? Somebody, I give compliments also, many more compliments than insult. But we hold on to that one insult. So there is flowers coming on you, and there is shit also coming on you. What do you take? Up to you. That is the skill. How do you get that? In fact, it's not just we stand in front, we dive and catch also. That person told like that to him about me. You, aise kaise bol diya? Usne kaise bol diya? Kabhi nahi bhulunga main. I will never forget that person. Oh, don't forget. Keep it with you. Who's the loser? Okay. One more game. So, I will count 5 in my mind. And in those 5 seconds, you have to count all the round objects here. Round, spherical, whatever. Okay. Stop. How many did you count? Huh? 5, 3, 4, See, there are so many more. There are eyeballs. There are so many people who have their eyeballs are round, spherical, projector. These circles here, those things also you can count as round. There are so many. So, again, I will give you one more chance. Again, I will count five in my mind, and you have to count round objects. Okay, start. Okay, stop. How many? I actually gave you less time than before. Could you count more than what you counted before? Yes? Okay, tell me one thing. How many squares did you count? How many squares are here? Out of syllabus, huh? Question out of syllabus. See? Okay, now stop. This is how the mind works. Wherever you put your attention, that is what grows. Are you getting what I'm saying? Wherever you put your attention, that is what grows. So there are round objects, there are square objects. Life will give you both. It is where you spend your time and effort and energy. Are you getting what I'm saying? So, in Bhagavad Gita, Krishna says, Yoga Karmasu Kaushalam. Means, yoga is skill in action. Anytime you have seen, like whenever you do your job, you do negotiation, you have to negotiate, right? After you graduate, you will have to negotiate for your salary, or you may have to negotiate for a job, or you may have to negotiate for a deal, whatever. Negotiation or skill. So wherever you have skill, it is because of yoga. Yoga has happened, you have become skillful. So yoga is, don't think yoga is just asanas. Posture, we do one this posture like that is yoga. No. Yoga is skill in action. Anyone who is very skillful, he is very centered. You cannot be skillful unless you are very centered, unless you are a yogi. Are you getting what I'm saying? But then what stops us? What stops us from being skillful, getting more centered? What stops us? Huh? Us. I would say, Kuniya Rabbi. Stress is the reason. Stress is the reason why you feel stressed out, basically. What stops you from being centered, being a yogi? And what is stress? What is stress? Too much to do. No time and no energy. Huh? Kya hua? What? Time? So, stress is too much to do, no time and no energy. Now, too much to do. There is some work you have taken up. Can you reduce that? No, you have that, you have to do. No time. Now, time, everyone has 24 hours. Can you do anything about it? No. 24 hours, time is there, everyone has 24. But, no energy. There you can do something. Energy. Increasing our energy level. So a yogi has a very high energy level. But how do you do that? How do you increase your energy levels? Are you seeing? This is the only way. Now, too much to do, you can't do anything. to no time, you can't do anything, no energy. Here you can do something. What can you do? Where do I have to point this? This thing? There, no? So, you know, there was a research in Stanford, and they calculated, they asked the people who graduated from there that in your new jobs, they are very successful. You've heard of Stanford University? Yeah. So, very successful people there. And then they asked those people there that after joining your job, how much of your domain knowledge did you utilize? And how much of your soft skill do you utilize? And here is the answer. Domain knowledge, you understand what is that? What do you study? Like, if you are an engineer, if you are an electrical engineer, then you electrical machines and how does motor run and how does high voltage DC transmit, all those things. So technical domain knowledge, 15% and 85% of your soft skills. Soft skills means how you communicate, what is your body language, what is your attitude in life, how you behave with people, how you those kind of things. So 85%, and tell me one thing, how much of our time, resource and energy do we utilize to get this? Time, okay, let's come to time. In 24 hours, or in our whatever age, 21, 22, 23 years, how much time have we utilized to get this domain knowledge? All our life, whole focus is that, isn't it? Domain knowledge, match padho, ye padho, wo padho, wo padho, ye padho. It's all domain knowledge. And soft skills, which is 85%, how much of time, effort and money do we utilize to get this? Are you seeing this? Yeah? So, we have no idea what our capacity is, what we really want, what we really want to do. Okay, let's do one more game. Everyone stand up. And clap. Stop. Clap. Stop. Okay. Now take your right hand in front. Thumbs up. Okay. Now turn to your right and turn as much as you can. And once you have reached your limit, mark a point behind you. Till wherever you can stretch, hold the position there. And mark a point behind you to just gauge how much you can do. And come back. Once you have done that, come back. Okay, now, wait. Thumbs up. Now, you turn to the right. Abhi, you went to the right. Now, take your hand to the left and head to the right. Okay? Okay, now come back. You can keep your hand down. Okay, again, take your hand up now. Now, take your right thumb. Again, twist to the right and see how much you can go now. Okay, come back. Sit down. So we think that we know everything. Humko pata hai, sab pata hai. It's not like that. there are teachers, there are people, there are saints who have knowledge which is something much beyond than what we can even imagine. Yeah? So this pranayam, asanas, meditation, all that will give something that is even beyond our imagination. Yoga is that. Of course, it will give you results in your reality also, in this physical realm also, but it gives you something even beyond that. And you can't even imagine. Could you imagine that you could do that much? If somebody tells you that, okay, do like this and then do, then you can do, no? You saw that? So like that, this pranayam, asanas, pranayam, dhyan, meditation, all that is like that. If you are lucky to have someone who has experienced that and who can come and guide you on that, isn't that, aren't we lucky to have that? Yeah? So, yoga basically is, it has 8 limbs. Yama, Niyam, Asan, Pranayam, Pratyahar, Dharana, Dhyan, Samadhi. Okay? So we will not do a lecture on each one of them. We are going to experience. Do you want to?
Yes, sir.
Are you sure?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So we won't do each one of them because some of them you should be doing anyways. Yama, Niyama. So we will do a little bit of asanas. Maybe, but there's not much space. Whatever we can do now, we'll see. Come. So, just asana is for the body level, okay? Kya karenge? You want to do something? Yes? Okay, what will we do? Okay. Everyone stand up. And just stretch. The way you stretch in the morning, when you wake up from your sleep. ऐसे नहीं खड़े होना. Whatever you feel, जो naturally होता है ना वो करना है. Shake your hands. That's why if you see babies, how simply if you look at them, they sit in Vajrasana so easily. Have you noticed that? And they do different postures. Yeah. So that's why this, which I said Angrai Lo, that is also a natural way of releasing body stress wherever it is. So shaking hands also help. Jump a little. Jump? What, you want music to jump? Up. Side. Come on, shake. Twist. Twist, come on. Hello. Main nahi karunga, wo dekh legi. Are? Come on, there, back. Woo! Okay. Come on. Oh, karke ruk gaye. Come on, keep jumping. Stop. No. What you are doing is, ek burst mein you will jump 5 times, like that, and then khade ho jayega. You have to do continuously. Okay, chalo, take your right hand on top of your head and massage your scalp. Press your scalp hard enough so that the skin moves, not your, you don't spoil your hairstyle. skin moves. One direction, then opposite direction. Acha. Then sideways. Both the sides. Shh. See. Hello. Front and back. One. If you pura din aapas mein baat karte ho, if you can just observe while doing this, observe what's happening inside, then there is something. Then you are going inward. Otherwise, you are just going outward and losing the energy. Okay, now, thumb under your eyebrow and both fingers above the eyebrow. Just massage your eyebrows. You can do. You all can do. You can also do. Thumb under your eyebrow. Hey, suno, udhar. Continue. औरों को नहीं दिखाने की जरूरत. Oh, देखो मेरे eyebrow. Under the eyes. Okay, at the base of the jaw. Okay, now move your lower jaw. Left and right. Exercise the lower jaw, left and right. And relax. Then what will we do? Open your eye, mouth. And close it tight. Open, close. Okay, and relax. Then breathe in, take your head back. Breathe out, bring your chin to the chest. And breathing in, take your head to the right. Take your head back, breathing in. And breathing out, take your head from the left down and chin to the chest. Then breathing in to the right. Continue, make 3 circles with the breath, rotating your head. Your eyes closed if you wish to, and even your mouth closed. And now come to the center. Now rotate your shoulders, and again with your breath, breathe in up, breathe out down, breathe in up, breathe out down, breathe in up, breathe out down, breathe in up. Opposite direction. Feeling good? Feeling better?
Yes.
Rotate fully. How many of you experience neck pain, upper back pain, shoulder pain, back? Oh my God. Okay, this one. This one is very effective for that. Keep your hands to the side. I know it's difficult, there's not much space. Okay, shh. Hey, we'll get delayed now. Time coming. Pull your fingers to, pull the fingers inward towards the face. Do you feel a strain here in this region? Yeah. So pull the fingers, okay, and hold it there. And now rotate, Tata. उंगलियों को खींचना है अंदर की ओर. Pull the fingers. See, some of you are doing like that. No. Pull the fingers towards the face and Tata. Continue. If it's paining, give a big smile. Face. And relax. Okay, now hands on your waist and rotate your waist. And hello, सामने देख के नहीं करना है, अपने आप को देख के करना है. चलो घूमो opposite direction. Just be with yourself, okay? You can even close your eyes and come back to the center. Shh. Okay, we'll have to stop then. You're enjoying?
Yeah.
Okay. So, yoga is going inward, huh? Going inward. Now, what happens? You should have more energy. You talk and you expend that. Are you getting what I'm saying? So when you feel it is basically again you have gained some energy and then you utilize to crack a joke or look. You lose that, and that moment again you lose it. So that is why they say yoga for some time just. Have a little bit of control. This is all. That's why yam niyam. Remember. So just for some time, say okay, yar, 3 jokes kam maar lunga main. Thoda log kam hans lenge. Kuch nahi hota. Just for this duration, just if you can do it, that will give you the best result. If you can't, that will not give you as good. Okay. So now waist rotation done. Acha others we cannot do now. Okay, jump again. Take your hands. Take your hands. And okay. And sit down. Not on your chairs. Not on your chairs. On your easy chairs. So hand in front. Hold the position. Hold the position. Shh. Okay. Hey, kya camera member? Come down little more. Hold the position. Shh. What is there to talk in this? Hold the position. Come down little more. And sit down. Sit down. On the chair. Okay. No need to clap. I've said clap 4 times though. Stop. I just remembered. Okay. So this was little bit of glimpse of asanas, you can say, but you need a little more space and there are much more intricacies to it. But do you feel a little light and refreshed?
Yes.
Just little movement has done that. So asanas is part of that. And now we'll do what is called pranayam. What is pranayam? Pranayam means pranayam. What is pran? Life force energy. All that is okay. But what is pran? Breath? Huh? Soul? Mind? Pran? Pran Shakti. You want to feel, experience what is prana? Yes? Okay. Shake your hands. Shake your hands really hard. Shake it so hard that your fingers should fall down. Shake it so hard, fingers should fall down. I don't see any fingers falling. Come on, shake. and relax. Keep your hands on your knees. Do you feel those tingling sensations on the fingertips? That is prana flowing in high velocity through your fingers right now. So, that is prana energy, prana. Prana flowing through your fingertips. You never thought, no? Okay, so we will do pranayam. Through breath, we do, using our breath, we do pranayam. We will do what is called bhastrika pranayam. Keep your hands like this. Elbows close to your rib cage. Okay, now as we move from asana to pranayam, we go a little more subtle. And so we have to go even more, little more inward. Okay? So we start reducing talking, just be with yourself more. So we will do this bhastrika pranayam and then we will experience meditation. Okay? So from this moment on, if you can keep your eyes closed if you want and mouth definitely closed. Okay? So bhastrika is, keep your hands like this and throw your hands up and breathe in and down and breathe out. In, out. In, out. In, out. Eyes closed. Keep your eyes closed now. Everyone close your eyes. Breathe in. Take your hands up. Out. In, 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 out. And relax. Keep your eyes closed. Don't open your eyes. Eyes remain closed, okay? Observe the sensations in the body. Observe the flow of energy in the body. Those who are sitting on the steps, you can spread out a little. Come forward so that there is more space. Now, if not for your sake, don't disturb others. Okay? Otherwise, I'll send someone, those who are making noise, they can leave the hall. Come again later. Eyes closed. Observe the sensations in the body. We will do one more round of bhastrika pranayam. Take position. Fist lightly closed in front of your shoulders. Take a normal deep breath in. And breathe out. Now this time when we breathe in, we will throw our hands up. Okay? Breathe in. Out. In. Out. In. Out. In. Out. In, out, 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 and relax. Observe the sensations in the body. Observe the effect of doing this bhastrika. And one last round of bhastrika. Take position, fist lightly closed in front of your shoulders. Take a normal deep breath in and breathe out. Now in bhastrika, when we throw our hands up with the breathe in, breathe in, out, 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 and relax. Observe the sensation. Utarne hai to utar bhi sakte. You can keep your eyes closed. Keep your eyes closed. Or just sit however you are. Sit comfortably there. Hands on your thighs, palms facing the ceiling.
Let's sit comfortably and easily. And let's close our eyes. Let's take a deep breath in and breathe out with a ha sound. In breathing and breathe out through the mouth. Incoming breath energizes the body and outgoing breath relaxes the body. Breathe in once again and slowly breathe out. As you breathe out, relax your arms, shoulders. Let's take our attention to our navel region. Have all your attention to navel, stomach, abdomen, liver, this region. Breathe in, as you breathe in, expand your stomach. And as you breathe out, pull your navel in. Squeeze your tummy. Once again, breathe in and bloat your stomach. And as you breathe out, pull back your navel. And relax. Become aware of the weight of your body. Once again, take a deep breath in. And as you slowly exhale, place the entire weight of your body on the chair or on the floor you are sitting. Become aware of any unpleasant feelings, sensation. And just accept them. Do not try to get rid of any unpleasant feelings. Little more attention in your navel area. Let this feeling of jealousy, loss, betrayal just be there. Let it consolidate. Let any negative feeling that is there solidify as you breathe in and breathe out. Breathe in and breathe out. Accept all these negative emotions. Let them be there. With a smile on your face, take another deep breath in and breathe out. Breathe in with a smile and breathe out with a smile. If you're feeling a sense of loss, grief, jealousy, or love, just let it be. Have your attention on the stomach, liver, abdomen, navel area. Observe your breath. It's either steady or shaky. It's either warm or cool. Take a few deeper breaths. And keep relaxing your whole body. Dive into that sense of loss. Embrace any negative feelings and sensation with both your arms. Thank you. Embrace all the negative feelings, restlessness, discomfort. Once again, take a deep breath with a smile and breathe out. We're not in a hurry to get rid of any stress or strain. We'll assimilate the stress and transform them. Few more deep breaths. For our breath can bring metamorphosis. It can change all the negative feelings into peace and harmony. Become aware of your mind. Your mind is surrounding the body and pervading every particle of your body. You are in and outside the body. Our attention can transform mud to gold, coal to diamond, and all negative feelings can become peace and compassion. Keep your attention on the navel region and observe any pleasant or unpleasant sensation. Deeper breath in and relax. Let every particle of our being be peaceful. Let every cell in our body be rested this very moment. Another deep breath in, and as you breathe out, relax more. Let go all your efforts and simply relax. Padi Sham Chatushpadi Om Shanti Shanti Shanti. Slowly and gradually become aware of body and surroundings. Take another deep breath in, and as you breathe out, relax even more. Once again, take a deep breath in, and as you slowly breathe out, may open your eyes.
How is it? Good? Raise your thumbs up if it was good for you. Only if it was good. You found it good? Raise your hand. Good.
The house is open for question-answer session.
Good evening, sir. So I have a question that I tried to meditate a lot, many times. Like it's 15 minutes, 20 minutes. I try to release every stress which I have. But for instance, I release those stress, but after a while, again, those thoughts come in my mind.
Yeah.
And I struggle with that a lot. From last 2 years, I'm trying in different ways.
How are you trying? Do you have, like, you have learned?
Yeah, in like from YouTube and discussing those.
No, no. See, ye sab hanky-panky nahi karo. Idhar udhar se nahi. If you learn from properly someone who is established, you learn in, for every other thing we have a teacher, no? For meditation you should have in proper guidance. For the simplest of thing, we for typing we take a teacher and learn typing from them. or for cycling, but such subtle things you should learn from a proper instructor.
Actually, there is one institution. I took a first Diksha from them, but I can't relate with them.
Okay.
Like
you try Sudarshan Kriya.
Sudarshan.
Flat. Sudarshan Kriya is something that everyone does, and you have no other option but to go into meditation. Everyone, whoever does Sudarshan Kriya, seedha meditation mein jaate.
Thank you so
try
much.
Try that.
Thank Hello, you, sir. My name is Roshni. So, can we cure hypothyroidism with the help of yoga or any asana?
Any disease, the base of that disease, 99% of the diseases, the base of that is in your mind. First, it comes in the mind, then it shows in the body. You know that? So, if you attend to your mind, it will not show in the body. But if it has already shown in the body, then you can take maybe Ayurveda, something, and then do. But meditation, Sudarshan Kriya will definitely help.
Okay, sir, thank you.
It has cured, people have got cured from random diseases. They've got cured. Asthma, even spondylitis, you name it, any disease, many of the diseases people have got cured just doing Sudarshan Kriya. I don't think those details you have to find out.
Okay. Good evening, sir. Yeah. My name is Rajat. And as we all know, sir, that we have very short amount of time to do yogas and meditation, sir. But in short, I would like to know, sir, that what we can do to avoid overthinking and avoid reactive. Overthinking and reactive,
overthinking.
Sir. Being reactive.
See, it is a question of efficiency. You know, when Gandhiji used to meditate every day. And the days he would be very busy, he would say, today I am very busy, I have to meditate 2 times. So, if you are very busy, if your schedule is very tight, you definitely need to meditate. Don't say, बहुत बिजी है मेडिटेशन नहीं उल्टा ज्यादा बिजी है सी इन्वेस्टमेंट इज व्हाट 20 मिनट्स एंड टाइम गिवन इज 2 आवर्स और 4 आवर्स 4 आवर्स ऑफ स्लीप नो 20 मिनट इन्वेस्ट करके 4 आवर मिल रहा है तो ये कहां का बिजनेस सेंस है भाई आर यू गेटिंग व्हाट आई एम सेइंग
यस सर
टू से आई डोंट हैव टाइम टू मेडिटेट is a completely nonsensical equation. If you are very busy, all the more reason you should meditate. You guys have no idea, you have enjoyed this meditation. Many people who are very free, they don't enjoy meditation. Because they don't know what is being busy. Yeah?
I, Rameshwari Pillai, express my profound gratitude to our guest, Mr. Vishal Merrani, Secretary to Gurudev Sri Sri Ravi Shankar Ji. We student managers are experiencing a jubilant environment because of your presence, sir. As it is well said, written words can't express, but the speeches can. And yes, you can feel my happiness because I got the golden opportunity to thank you. So, thank you for sparing your valuable time and encouraging us to lead a fit and healthy life ahead with the help of yoga. We are privileged to have Bala ma'am in this auspicious evening. Thank you, Bala sir, for giving us an opportunity to know more about yoga. Thank you.
Thank you. Bye.